Pods termination is a normal process within any cloud-native environment. Pods are designed to fail to allow an application to scale up or down. In this video, we are going to cover the pod termination process, how you can control it, and how to avoid the dangerous mistake of unsafe termination. Let's go. Pods are ephemeral units of work that actually designed to be terminated. And here we can see like a common scenario example of users that are working during the day with your application. We can see the scale up of pods during the morning and the scale down of pods later at the evening. And during the time of the scale down, there is a massive pod termination to support the scale of the user that actually needed, because we don't want to keep pod alive to not do any work. And this is part of a cloud native environment. And there are more triggers to pod termination. For example, when we want to roll out a new version of our deployment, the old pods are going to be terminated. And also when someone forced termination. And this is like the nature of cloud native environment, this kind of scaling and termination. So after we find out what can trigger pod termination and how common it is, let's deep dive into the process itself. So the process of termination actually have two types of termination. The graceful termination, when Kubernetes let the application or the pod to shut down itself. It's like when you click on your computer, shut down, and wait for the computer to shut down gracefully. The other type is the ungraceful shutdown. It's a brutal shutdown when Kubernetes terminate the pod immediately. It's like when you click on your computer for a few seconds on the power button. So what happens is Kubernetes trigger a graceful shutdown, stop the request to go through the service, and then it waits for 30 seconds. In the 30 seconds time is the time for the pod to shut down itself. And if not, Kubernetes will execute the ungraceful shutdown. After we understand the process in high level, the time from the graceful shutdown to the ungraceful shutdown, now you may ask yourself, how Kubernetes interact with my application and pod in order to tell it that this is the graceful shutdown? So there are like three ways. One, which is by default, is the Linux signals away. When there is a graceful shutdown, you get the SIGTERM, making your application to be terminated. You need in your application to write the code to catch the termination signal and do whatever work needed it to be closed. The two other ways, which are not default and you need to configure it using the preStop configuration, are using a HTTP request that the kubelet going to trigger within your pod, or a script, pre-made script that you can write a path to it. On the other side, you need to make sure in the application that you handle the script, the HTTP request, or the Linux signal in order to make sure that you closed everything. There are slight or some configuration that can be done in order to, first of all, delay the termination, because for some application, 30 seconds is not enough. Then you want to extend it to 60, maybe 90 seconds. It's more common for legacy application, so I would not recommend that you to do that, but sometimes you need to use this configuration. The other thing is that you need to configure the pre-stop. If you are using HTTP request or some script in order to execute or shut down your pod, then you need to configure the pre-stop. So, what are the common problems of not handling pod termination? So first of all, is not handling request. Not handling request means that request went into the pod did not stop the request from flowing or did not process it fast enough, then the pod shut down ungracefully and the request actually on hold and your consumers or user do not get the response on the right time and getting timeout. So make sure that when you get the signals, you or process the request or send some error to the users and force it to retry. The second thing is to not close connection to database or queues, and then you get like a lot of open connection within your databases and they are forcing like to not create new one when a new pod spawn up. The last thing is worker type of apps when they read message from queues. And sometimes they do not stop the processing and then the message need to be re-queued on the queue. It makes the data processing going through delay, and you obviously don't want delays within your data pipelines. So those are the three common issue or mistakes causing you problems. It can be slight, but on an scale, they can be a huge impact within your metrics, within your users. So make sure that you want to take care of these. Now that you are an expert in pod termination, if you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much.